Many people believe that today's dogs are far too domesticated to fend off a pack of wolves, and that's honestly not true. Many dog breeds today were bred for specifically guarding livestock from fierce predators such as bears and wolves, and wolf killing is simply embedded in their DNA. With that said though, let's meet some of those dogs, shall we? From an Irish breed specifically developed for wolf hunting to a guard dog so fierce it's actually banned in the US, here are 10 dogs that can kill wolves. Number 10. The Irish Wolfhound. The Irish Wolfhound, as its name implies, was bred to chase down wolves, so there's no question if one of these dogs can best a wolf in a fight. In fact, they have a long history of fighting off predators such as coyotes, wolves, and even more dangerous predators. They were developed from warhounds into a dog that was used for hunting and guarding specifically. One of the most ancient dog breeds, the Irish Wolfhound may have been brought to Ireland as far back as 7000 BC. Although they were originally bred to be expert hunters, today's Irish Wolfhounds make excellent human companions. They are quiet, reserved, intelligent, and easygoing. This breed is also the tallest of all dogs, even taller than the Great Dane. Males often stand as tall as 34 to 35 inches from foot to shoulder blade and stand over 7 feet tall on their hind legs. They can weigh upwards of 140 pounds, and while standing on all fours, the Irish Wolfhound size can easily be comparable to a donkey. Number 9. The Central Asian Shepherd. The Central Asian Shepherd dog is a big, strong, and independent dog breed who don't need no human. They go by several other names, including the Central Asian Ovcharka, the Alibi, the Middle Asian Ovcharka, and the Mid-Asian Shepherd. They are also one of the oldest breeds, and their genetics can be traced back over 5,000 years. The Central Asian Shepherd is an affectionate family pet, noted for its devotion to its people. It gets along well with its family members and also has a patient demeanor with children. But gentle as they are both big and powerful, and they were bred to be that way. Originally, they were used for herding, guarding, and protecting flocks of sheep against a variety of predators, which include, of course, a pack of wolves. It is naturally suspicious and will quickly go on the defensive when it identifies a threat. It will alert its owners to any intrusions with a loud bark, resorting to protecting its charges, which often ends with the death of the intruder. Number 8. The Kangal. The Kangal dog is a large, powerful, heavy-boned dog whose size and proportions have developed naturally as a result of its continued use in Turkey. There over in Turkey, it acts as a guardian against predators. They were bred to guard shepherds' flocks against large predators including bears, wolves, foxes, and jackals in the mountains and plains of the Kangal district of Turkey. Shepherding sheep across large tracts of land have developed their agility, strength, and speed. This work has made them gentle with livestock and children and intimidating, and when there's a need, aggressive with predators and intruders. Their large, muscular stature, their massive head, and contrasting black mask on the face makes their appearance formidable. But the Kangal guards with intimidation rather than aggression. But these large and powerful dogs don't shy away from a fight, especially when it means the safety of the ones they are protecting. And when it comes to fights with wolves, the Kangal will almost always win. Number 7. The Commandeur. The Commandeur is a large and powerful guardian covered in a profuse amount of dreadlocks. It looks really chill, and you would fully expect to see one lounging on a porch listening to some tunes. However, Rasta looks aside, the Commandeur is actually a strong and alert sheepdog that has been used to guard livestock for centuries. A big male can stand more than 27.5 inches and weigh over 100 pounds, heavy-boned, deep-chested, and are very muscular as well. Despite their brawn though, the Commandeuric, which is what you call them in plural, are agile and light-footed, and move with long strides. With their unique look, it's impossible to mistake Comms for anything else. They are loyal, loving, and even-tempered dogs, which has also made them excellent family dogs, but they still have the protective instincts and make them a threat to predators like wolves and coyotes. One surprising fact about them is that they don't actually shed, and make for an excellent choice for those with allergies. That sensationally knotted coat, which is the breed's most unique characteristic, looks like it could need a wash, but surprisingly it's not really that smelly, depending on how you care for it, of course. Regular shampooing is a must, otherwise you'll end up with a dog that looks and smells like a floor mop. Number 6. The Armenian Wolfhound. The Armenian Gamper, or as it's also called, the Armenian Wolfhound, was bred specifically to protect pastures from mountain wolves. They appeared 2,500 years ago and have basically remained unchanged to this very day. Gampers grow to impressive sizes, and their endurance is considered one of the highest among dogs. Highlanders often tell stories of how a single Gamper can challenge and overcome an entire pack of wolves. Dogs of this breed have lived throughout the Armenian Highlands since prehistoric times, as evidenced by cave paintings found in various areas of historical Armenia. Among the 2,000 years old cave paintings discovered at the mountains of Ukhtasar and Jermajur and the Gegan mountain range, about 20% portray dogs similar to the modern Gamper. Historically, though, shepherd dogs have been used to protect herds and dwellings from predators and aggressors. The first mention of the use of large dogs by the troops of the Armenian king Tigran II dates back to the 1st century BC. Number 5. Perro de Presa Canario. Okay, honestly, just look at it and tell me it doesn't remind you of one of those zombie dogs from Resident Evil. The similarities don't end on looks alone, though. Kinda like the dogs in the game, this breed can be very vicious. Translated from Spanish, this breed's name literally means canary and catch dogs. It's also commonly known as the Canary Mastiff, but believe me, this dog is not as docile as a canary, despite its name. Its original purpose was to help out in farms as a farm dog and to herd farm animals. They may not be as large as other dogs on this list, but they have strong muscular builds that gives them enough physical strength to take on predators. Even more important is that they are quite dominant, territorial, and alert dogs, which makes them a real threat to predators like wolves in a one-to-one fight. I expect Presa Canario to have good chances against a wolf personally. They are also often used in dog fighting rings, where they duke it out with other known fighting breeds, which we will introduce to you later on in this list. Let me just point out that dog fighting is highly illegal and inhumane, so please don't support this activity. Number 4. The Borbul. The Borbul, pronounced Borbul, is a large guardian dog which is also known as the South African Mastiff. An impressive breed, they are one of the most powerful dogs in the world. They're able to exert more than 450 pounds of pressure per square inch when they bite. What does this mean, though? Well, a lion and great white shark exert around 600 pounds of pressure per square inch, so that gives you an idea. With its size and power, it's easy to think that these guys are highly aggressive. Well, they certainly look the part, but in actuality, they're not all that dangerous. Think of them as oversized puppies. It's unclear where the Borbul first ascended from, but it's thought that the Dutch, German, and Huguenot settlers brought large guardian dogs with them to South Africa. The interbreeding of these dogs eventually resulted in what we know as the Borbul dog, and as with all other breeds on today's list, they were bred to be fierce protectors against all kinds of predators. They're more than happy being family pets, too. Despite their size and power, they can actually be incredibly lazy dogs, probably one of the laziest dog breeds of all time. Number 3. The Dogo Argentino. Powerful, yet possessive and almost feline grace, the Dogo Argentino is a fearless yet sensitive, energetic outdoors yet calm indoors dog. Despite the intimidating appearance, the Dogo Argentino is usually friendly, yet is also a vigilant guardian with a thunderous bark. That is, with proper training and socialization. If not, then you've got a big problem on your hands. You see, they've been bred specifically to be hunting dogs and came about by mixing breeds primarily used for dog fighting. So you can just imagine how naturally aggressive this dog is going to be. This means they can give predators such as wolves and coyotes a very hard time. They're very loyal and territorial dogs, and they would jump at predators without a second thought. With that said, it's going to be pretty easy to imagine one of these canines besting even a pack of wolves. They're pretty energetic as well, and will find a way to use whatever pent-up energy that they have, and that usually results in chewed up couches and upturned trash bins if they can't find any predators to fight. Now it's time for the day's best pick. So if you come across a photo online and want to know more about it, just send it on over to us and we'll look into it for you. Who knows, might even feature it in a future video. With that said though, number 2. The Caucasian Shepherd. The Caucasian Shepherd, also known as the Caucasian Ovcharka, is a large dog breed from the Caucasus region and is one of the strongest and fiercest dogs around today. They grow very large, weighing around 110 pounds at the minimum. They can also reach an average of 12 years of age, which is a pretty long lifespan for a dog. They are alert, dominant, and strong dogs that are known to be able to kill wolves and other predators to protect livestock. Their bite force of 550 to 700 PSI is easily the strongest in the doggo world. This breed originated from Russia and other European countries, originally used as a guard dog for protecting livestock in the mountain regions. You probably noticed this, but the most dangerous dogs are those who were bred to guard something. But anyway, they've also become so good at their job that these dogs are even feared by some popular wild predators, such as wolves. Okay, yeah, you heard me right. Their presence alone is enough to deter one of the most vicious predators on Earth. With that said, I'm pretty sure these guys can easily take down wolves. Before we move on, do me a favor. My analytics show that only about 15% of you watching are actually subscribed. Come on guys, what's up with that? Can you guys please hit the subscribe button? You guys watch my videos every day anyway, so you might as well subscribe and keep up to date with every video we put out. Number 1. The Tibetan Mastiff. Now if there's a prize for the world's scariest looking dog, it's probably gonna go to the Tibetan Mastiff. This absolute giant dog originates from Tibet and belongs to the Mastiff family. They were originally bred to serve as guard dogs, protecting sheep and cattle from large predators, as well as its owners and their families. Its size alone is enough to intimidate even the hungriest of predators. They are also quite strong dogs with impressively strong wills and protective instincts. They're very dominant and territorial, and they don't like intruders of any species, making them very dangerous on wolves and other predators. But of course, the most protective dogs in the world often turn out to be the most dangerous dogs as well. There was a highly publicized case in China back in 2013 where a Tibetan Mastiff savagely attacked its owner's neighbor to the point that the neighbor suffered a brain hemorrhage. This probably led to the breed being banned in many Chinese cities. At the same time though, China bans things on a whim at this point, so I just take that with a grain of salt. What other dog breeds do you think can go mano a mano with wolves? Let us know down below in the comments. Also make sure to check out the channel's other amazing videos. As always, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Later, everybody!